Coming up on this episode of Swing Nation, we've got the magnificent Lindini, our buddy Jim's beautiful Lindy Hop iPad covers, and a rant-inspiring documentary. Swing Nation episode 26 starts now.
Hit that jive, close the door, get the carpet off the floor. Swing Nation,
people grooving together.
Truck on down, pimp your stroll, put some jelly on that roll. Swing Nation,
people grooving together.
Hey!
Hey.
Welcome to Swing Nation, episode 26. I'm Spuds. This is Zucker Punch. Not over there is Rick, the macho man.
Are you flossing your ears?
Watch that.
That's what you do.
That's what you do.
Squeak, squeak, squeak.
It's June 10th.
It is.
2013.
And welcome to the gun show. All right.
You can tell we're a little punchy today.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's punch it. So, some exciting news already right off the bat. We have to say, do this for the Mermaid Parade because they managed to raise $104 million.
It was not $104 million. It was $104,000.
There's some zeros.
Could you imagine? Could you imagine the mermaid costumes you could have with like $100 million?
You could actually like turn into a mermaid.
Right. You can get the surgery.
You could fund some. Yeah, you could
to
like
get the fins grafted onto your body.
So Spuds are surprised that they earned this much money within the time frame.
Okay. Let me just say
right?
that. Well, okay, let's just for people who haven't watched the last show, in New York, Coney Island, what is this? The largest art show in the world.
Art parade
on Coney Island in New York was threatened to be shut down this year because it's too popular. And what, it cost the city too much money to run? Something like that?
But you got to hire security. You got to hire, have an army of volunteers. It's expensive.
It's expensive to do. So.
And Rick in particular really wanted this Kickstarter that they had. Mm-hmm. To fund the parade to succeed because for the last few years, our people have kicked ass in the parade.
And correct. By our people, she means black people. No. Yehudi.
Yes.
Yehudi people.
Yes.
I mean.
Heather.
I mean us Lily black Blue. People.
Yehudi.com is always represented.
Am I ashy? Am I ashy today?
You need some lotion.
So Yehudites Misbehave and Lily Blue have been leading up the Brooklyn Bombshells, which are the winningest group in all Mermaid Parade history.
Yeah.
So without a Mermaid Parade, we can't keep winning.
Winning.
That's not going to happen.
So that's why the Kickstarter was successful, was because Rick was singularly up in arms about the fact that we might not be able to continue to be the winningest for lack of opportunity to win.
Yep. It's not like I gave any money. I just announced.
$104,000. Congratulations. Hopefully we get some good pictures from the Mermaid Parade.
And hopefully we continue winning, because otherwise...
It'll all be not.
Rick is going to be a little upset.
Yes. Is inspiration for our own fundraiser, for our own awesome participation at the International Lindy Hop Championships.
Nice segue.
Yeah, you like that?
Hey.
And we don't need 104... Well, we'll take it.
We don't need...
That would be a lot of remix shoes.
Oh, my gosh. I would have the most amazing shoe collection.
A lot of remix shoes. But, we could have a crew of, like, 50 people. It would be amazing.
Makeup.
But, yeah, we only want a measly...
I can't work like this, people. I'm going to my trailer.
$6,000. Nothing. Just knock that right out.
So. That's a fraction. Well, it is actually... I mean, like, 100... Or, like, 1 over 1 is also a fraction. This is a fraction of what the Mermaid Parade...
Yeah.
Yes.
...garnered. So, hopefully, with your guys' support, and maybe your friend's support, maybe people who are... you know, getting like year-end bonuses or whatever, want to contribute to our having some really good video quality and production values at ILHC, and hopefully for future events too that want us to cover their competitions, you can contribute to our little Indiegogo
thing. Yeah, exactly.
Thing. It's a wise investment in the future of Lindy Hop.
Yeah, in all seriousness, we really would like your support, and we really want to show off Lindy Hop the way the networks show off, football. We really want it to be out there and invisible. And thank you.
Yep. So let's go to our first feature. I don't know why I started with this downer, but here we are.
With this cautionary whale.
But it is something to be concerned about. This is Jason Sager. He is a DJ and dancer out of Raleigh, North Carolina. And he has a very sad story about his car getting broken into. And
so
all
what happened?
His DJ stuff gets jacked. So he, unfortunately, did not have backups. So that was his bad. But, of course, we have a lot of other swing DJs in the world. So if you are a DJ, back up your stuff. And then back up your backups. Put it in an external hard drive and mail it to your mom or something.
It was all digital?
It was CDs that he'd ripped.
Yeah, CDs that he'd ripped.
So he still has CDs.
He'd gotten the BPM on most of them.
So it's like the metadata.
Right. That takes a long time.
Yeah, and so he's like pretty much sitting there like putting the disc in. Getting it taken care of.
Wow.
Taking the disc out, putting the next disc in. Like, there's a pain in the ass. So, like, it's not like his collection is totally gone. Like, he's still got portions of it back, although there's some things that we just buy in digital copies these days. But, yeah, guys, back up. I mean, I need to back up my computer, too. This happened to Joanna Lucero, like, a month ago or so, too, where something happened with her computer and, like, her iTunes was just wiped.
Yeah.
And so she's, like, trying to recreate it, and she's like, oh, my God, my music. Fortunately, she had some of it on an iPod that she was able to get off, but otherwise, we're just kind of screwed.
I'm sorry about that, Jason. I'm a little bit insane at my house. We have a network-attached storage device that has 12 terabytes of data. We have
Come over to your house and back up?
And back up. All of our laptops are automatically time-machined into the NAS, every bit of data, and we have a backup disk of that in a fire cabinet, in a fire safe at home. I once almost lost a hard drive full of our photos and videos, and I managed to get the hard drive back up and running, and I never wanted that feeling ever again. Mm. That's why we have triple redundancy. We have RAID 5 at home, which is ridiculous. But it's really easy to do, people. If you have a Mac especially, get yourself Time Machine. Even if you don't have like an automatic thing, just use the Time Capsule software on the computer. If you have Windows, get yourself a backup program. It's the first 10 rules of computing are all backup. So, sorry about that, Jason.
Beep, beep.
But thank you for sharing your story so that other people can learn from your difficult lesson.
That?
That was backing up. This is backing up time. It's a beep, beep, beep.
Obviously. I mean, come on.
Hmm. Oh, goodness. Oh. We have a. Don't we have a special guest?
We do. I better leave so he could show up.
do you want us to do the other feature while Spuds goes and gets the other guest?
We can do that. Yes.
Oh, that's an excellent segue.
I know, isn't it?
Yes.
I'll be right back. I mean, nothing.
Yeah. So, I don't know if you all know our good buddy Jim Thorpe, but in addition to making Swing Nation happen for us for every episode, he also has this ridiculous thing that he does where he makes iPad covers, and I personally want one that has the TARDIS from Doctor Who on it, but this one is a Lindy Hop iPad cover. It's so pretty. So, I don't know if you can... No. Wait, come on, model it.
Oh, sorry.
Come on, there you go. So if you look at it, I don't know if you can see, but there's like this imprint in the middle that's like Kevin and Joe, and they're like iconic dancey type pose, and a nice pattern around the corners, and it's like nice leather, and it's, you know, it's like... Anyway, you should totally get one of these. He also does iPhones, yeah? iPhone 5. Because I wanted to do my iPhone 4, but apparently the size is, like, harder to do for the TARDIS design that I want. But it's awesome, and he hand-stitches them himself, and they're really beautiful. So, I mean, I don't know why you don't have one already.
I don't even have an iPad, and I want to get an iPad, so I can get one of these covers.
I was seriously considering it. Where,
like,
I was like, oh,
make it for my Kindle. He's like, no.
I was like, yeah, I totally need an iPad so that I can get an iPad cover that Jim makes.
You guys are the best. I love you.
So support a fellow Lindy Hopper who also does something really cool and crafty.
With Lindy Hop on it.
With Lindy Hop on it. Protect your device, you know.
I mean, also TARDIS, if you're, like, into that, like I am. But, you know, Lindy Hop
TARDIS.
Kevin and Joe on your iPad, and then you open it up, and there's a picture of Kevin and Joe.
So we'll post the links to Jim's Etsy, so you can Etsy him. I don't know if that's a verb. And order it.
I think our guest is ready, though.
Huh?
I think our guest is ready.
Is our guest ready?
I don't know.
Goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a truly great moment in Swing Nation history.
A momentous occasion.
We have a visitor all the way from Lenox Avenue in Harlem. The famous sage, seer, all-knowing, all-seeing, former master of ceremonies at the Cheesecake Factory. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Lindini.
It's Lindini.
Lindini, yes. Sorry, my teleprompter is out.
A one, a two.
Well, we have a large audience of Lindy Hoppers anxious to see and hear your great wisdom. I have the envelopes here. A child of four can plainly see that they have been hermetically sealed and kept in a mayonnaise jar on Nina Gilkinson's porch since noon today. No one knows the contents of these envelopes, but you and your incredible divine powers will ascertain the answers for even seeing the questions. Is that right, a magnificent Lindy?
Of course. Now, I need to have absolute silence so that I may divine the answers, even though the questions have been sealed.
Yes, we know. You said that already.
That's my line.
Oops.
Yeah. And make sure you hand them to me in order, because the choke ties.
Oh, is that
okay,
why,
let's get this
is that
started.
Why there's numbers on them?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Here's the first envelope.
Two weeks. Yes, 2 weeks.
2 weeks. What could... 2 weeks.
The time most new dancers spend before trying the advanced Lindy level.
These are getting better, right?
God, I hope so.
4 or 5 times.
Four or five times.
The number of times dancers request the song I Like Pie in 1 hour.
I like that song.
The Black Keys.
The Black Keys.
Black, guess what? I just said. How do the Swedes refer to Stephen Mitchell, Ryan Francois, and Manu Smith?
The Black Keys.
Yes, I got it. I wish I didn't, but I got. Will you quit throwing paper around?
May you get in a push-up battle with Nick Williams.
I've seen him do push-ups. He does a lot of them.
Heidi Ho.
Heidi Ho.
Yes, what is going on here is what I just said. Heidi Ho.
Heidi Ho.
These envelopes are effective. How do you say hello to your D-Ho?
What?
May Joe Hofberg be the commentator for your wedding dance.
Wow. That would be amazing. You know she's going to have to be now.
Wow.
This is very difficult work. A mini dip.
Mini dip.
A mini dip.
This is going to be cheesy as hell, isn't it?
Aren't they all? A mini dip. What do you call sex with a short Lindy Hopper?
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
Dax Hawk.
Dax Hawk.
Dax Hawk. Why are you... What? That's what I said.
I'm really
That's where it's going. What do you do when you get some Dax caught in your throat?
Seriously?
Oh, boy.
May you find out that you are the illegitimate child of Mikey Pedroza and Norma Miller.
That would be a hilarious night. Bow, 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 bow. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm interrupting the Green Lindy.
My divining, yes. Splanky, Squatty Roo, and Digga Digga Doo.
Splanky, Squatty Roo, and Digga Digga Doo.
That is correct. Name three Lindy Hop STDs.
Oh, I hold in my hand the last envelope, ladies and gentlemen. Yes.
All right, let's get it over with. I need it other places in other dimensions. Bliers.
Bliers.
Bliers. What do you call people who can't tell the truth?
I told you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
A two.
The Magnificent Lindini. Thank you, a great one, for joining us. How did he do that? That was amazing.
Oh my god. I saw the awesomest thing on the Facebooks today. Completely unrelated to the Lindy Hop, but related to my other favorite thing, which is cheese.
Okay.
It's just a white text on a black background, and it's alternate lyrics to the Eurythmics song "Sweet yes. Dreams," and it's come on, sing it with me.
I'm not singing with this one.
Sweet dreams are made of cheese. Who am I to disagree? I cheddar the world and the feta cheese. Everybody's looking for Stilton.
Oh, God.
Wow. Wow. That needs to happen.
Is this what you guys do where I'm gone?
Yes.
Is this what happens when I leave for 5 minutes? How was the Lindini? He was great, right?
Amazing.
Yeah, I know. He was awesome.
I mean, honestly, us singing a cheese version of the Eurythmics is probably equally entertaining.
Wow.
Snap.
Pretty good.
Wow.
All right.
Wow.
That's because our rendition of the song was just like so
spot
breathtaking,
on,
right?
I was anyway.
It was so good.
I was trying. Are we at, should we mention this quickly, this blog?
Yeah, apparently. Like, people actually watch this show and it makes a
difference.
I just
keep clicking on it.
Not after that sketch.
Yeah, probably not. So I'm sorry, guys. But so our homegirl, Gina Helfrich, posted or Helfrich.
I just like to say it.
Helfrich with a k sound, not a
Helfrich.
Ch sound.
Not a Helfrich.
Helfrich.
Oh, Helfrich.
Helfrich.
Okay.
I know it's a CH.
Anyway, that person.
She wrote a blog post in response or after watching the episode where my arm was in a sling about how she keeps herself healthy. She had a knee problem that she was awesome and just made better. And I should probably follow in her suggestions and like get a personal trainer and make myself better and stuff like that. Chances are I won't, but you go, girl. So check out her blog, Dance with Gina.
dancewithgina.wordpress.com.
And isn't that
She's
a pretty
so
picture
awesome.
Of her? How I fixed my knee problem and accidentally got in the best shape of my adult life. She is in amazing shape. True story.
We love Gina. Yeah, it's really, really nice, really lengthy, informative post, and thank you so much for writing that, Gina.
And she's a good writer and a smart lady, also an amazing dancer. God damn you. That's just not fair.
Better than me. All right,
she's better than most of us.
Yeah.
Are you video time
video
yet?
Time
video time.
Yeah, let's get to a video that you
yes.
hate.
So we're gonna show something I usually like, which
oh,
is
God.
Electro swing, and it's, we're gonna show some dancing that I don't have a huge problem with.
Is this considered electro swing? Because
no.
We're talking the Will I Am video, right?
I think Jesse Miner would be our resident expert. We'd have to ask about it. But you can be the judge. Will I Am spelled his name very strangely with his song Bang Bang.
Toot 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 to the game.
Huh?
can't leave her. Forever, I always need her. She lied, but I believe her. Love sick, I got that fever. Love stupid, I know it. Love stupid, I know it. I know, cause I'm a fool in love. My baby shot.
They're not
me
really
down
playing
again.
Those instruments. Just saying.
Shut up.
Oh, they're not? Are you sure?
Bang, bang. I have a suspicion.
That girl's a killer from a gang. Shot me down with a love and it go bang, bang. And oh, I love her, so that's why I gotta let her know that I'll be here for her to always.
I think it's hilarious that this part of the video is like all about his crotch.
Oh.
Hey,
Chelsea.
All right, we good?
Please.
So
I hope
right.
One day I'm like half as sassy as that girl.
Did you guys like that?
Okay.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I loved it. Okay. Not a big fan of Electric Swing, but the reason is maybe I get too fixated on the one thing that I think he did really well. One shot, wide.
Yeah.
No takes.
Thank you. No like quick switches.
I thought that was to be vintagey. Like, well, similar to the black and white
fine.
And the scratchy.
They fine. Did it. For whatever totally reason, fine. I'm just glad it wasn't like, cut, cut, cut.
I admit, I may be fixating on that and elevating everything else with it, but I felt so, I was so grateful that it was just like, these guys rehearsed. They rehearsed the routine, and they're doing it, and there's one shot, and that's it, and they're and it's just, you know.
It's Charleston. It's not like they're, like, swinging out or anything. It's Charleston. That's totally legit. It's not like the most interesting choreography on the planet, but it's tightly done, and I thought it was good.
It's a terrible song.
That's it. You don't have
can't
to like
save.
The song.
Can't
fine.
Save it. And his emceeing is terrible.
I'm sorry.
But otherwise,
anyway,
well done.
Next.
Well done. I guess I should set it. I think I'm the only one who actually watched this entire thing. This is
no,
a...
No, I watched this.
Oh, you didn't watch it? Okay.
I watched it on the train on the way here.
So this is a gentleman in Perth, Australia, who wanted to, I'm not exactly sure about his motivations, I don't know if you remember, but he was like, I don't know anything about dancing, I'm a terrible dancer, and I'm going to go to one of the Perth's big dance competitions, Hullabaloo, and I'm going to compete, having known nothing about swing dancing prior to Hullabaloo. So he did a little bit of beginner lessons and got some coaching from some good dancers. And then here is him on the way to the Hullabaloo dance competition.
So, James, what kind of complications have we encountered so far?
Well, before I started dancing, they had a little wardrobe malfunction, which I'm going to have to fix with some tape and some blue tack. It seems that the heel of my shoe has decided to part ways with the rest of the shoe.
As I trudge towards certain doom, I try to remember everything Robbie has taught me.
I'm just calling out my number, then at 10 o'clock, that's when I'm gonna be competing in front of all the people here. But that's all right, I just kind of remember the 6 beat, and once that happens, nothing to it, right?
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Like,
so spoiler alert, he doesn't win. Sorry.
First of all, the hat has to go.
There's a whole section of him getting his wardrobe.
Second of all, I'm not even going to start with the suspenders. Second of all, I feel like it's insulting to people who, like, do this dance, invest in it, spend time in it, for people who have, like, barely done it ever before in their lives to go, like, oh, I'll compete. What have I got to lose? Because you know what? Like, in a partner dance competition, you are attached to someone else's hand, and you could seriously be screwing up their chances of doing well. Yeah. So it's not just like, oh, what have I got to lose? Yeah, what have you got to lose? What does your partner have to lose? What are you inflicting on them?
Yeah, it's a good point, and you can see that a little bit in the beginning. And to be clear, this is a Jack and Jill competition, so he gets it's not like he comes in with his regular partner, who was also a beginner. That'd be one thing, and like entered a strictly. He's going into Jack and Jill, where he gets randomly paired with some poor girl who has to dance with somebody who's barely taken a couple of lessons. So totally take your point.
And I've been in competitions like that, and like when I'm on the social floor and it's not a competition and someone asks me to dance and I say yes, like it's on me when I'm dancing with them and they're new and I just have to deal with that. But like in a Jack and Jill, I have no choice. I am stuck with you, and if you rip my arm out of my socket, I have to keep dancing. There's no like, oh, I'm injured, I have to walk off the floor. I'm stuck with you. Mm-hmm. Don't be a jerk. Don't be that guy or that girl. But I feel like guys do it more.
Well, I have to agree, and but I'm going to agree. I'm agreeing with you guys that it's kind of disrespectful. It seemed like a very contrived way to make a documentary. It's shot really well. It's good cuts. It flows very well. I watched the whole. It's 8 minutes. I watched the whole thing. It just didn't seem to resonate with me why he would be motivated to do this outside of I'm going to make a documentary and, yeah. Oh, here's an idea that I have. Because at the end of it, he says, I don't think I would ever dance again. And it's like, well, you A, didn't give it a shot. B, you kind of shit all over everybody who loves this dance. And C, you just did it because you wanted to make a documentary. The documentary is great. The content.
So then why bother? Like, you know, with the best film quality in the world, if the content is shit, why would you bother?
Well, it's shit to us. It's not shit to somebody who's like, yeah. Possibly it's not shit to somebody who's like, oh, it was very good, very, very, very interesting. Okay, great. We'll sign you up to do other ones, whatever. It just didn't resonate with me because it was very...
Yeah. So I think okay. The thing about doing little documentaries like this is it is cool to see it from the perspective of somebody who knows nothing and what it is like to come in as a complete beginner and deal with all of that anxiety and frustration it takes when you're learning something new. But also you want to get to that moment of discovery where they're just like, hey, I learned this thing and it felt really good, or my partner smiled, I made her smile, or like I heard the music in a different way. I was hearing jazz that I didn't like before.
Yeah,
now I can hear something.
We never get there with this.
Literally at the end, he's like, I don't think I'm going to do this.
I don't think I'm ever going to do this.
Like, it's a really weird place to leave your viewer.
And scene. And then credits.
Credits and hey, where's my award
at
cons?
You have to give us the validation of like, oh, I grew as a result of this thing. But like, you can find a lot of people who experience that anxiety of competing, of who like are pretty new, who are doing this for the first time. There's a world of people who are entering their first competition who have spent a little more time doing the dance beforehand. Who like have a little more solid grounding in what it's about, at least.
Yeah. All right. Well. well. Okay.
So let's see some actual awesome Lindy Hop competition.
Yes,
footage.
Please.
Yeah.
So we were on the Camp Jitterbug train last show, and we're still on that train, and we're going to show you a little bit of the awesome Strictly Lindy competition.
Who's who?
That's Gabby Cook and Mikey Pedroza.
Mikey Pedroza.
I thought they looked fantastic.
Oh, Mikey's in the shot? Oh, I'm sorry. I was staring at Gabby.
Oh. He's the brown one. That was nice. This is like a palate cleanser for you guys again.
Now,
Brittany and Dargoff.
Dargoff.
Yeah. Dargoff, yeah. Something about him that I just dig.
He is so much fun to dance with.
He's just super wacky.
He's like,
fearless.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Right. I really like that they dance like this, and that like she doesn't always have to look like really pretty in her dancing. And that they embrace the awkward.
Milk it.
Daryl and Jen from Providence. Their dancing is like normally just really clean.
Yeah.
And really pretty.
Sock choice is essential, gentlemen.
That's Daryl. I've always looked up to her dance. Her swing is just super nice. Jen Applegarth. Mm-hmm. That dress is amazing.
I think they won.
They did. Adam, I'm not going to try to pronounce your last name. I'm sorry.
And we should finish with the cover.
Yeah, let's finish with these guys. Whoa. Ooh.
I feel like maybe like a little too much of this competition was choreographed.
Yeah, a little bit. So that's Crystal and Joe. Remember just for them. They were ridiculous. I love them.
Wow.
I still don't understand the trick. I've seen it like a couple times.
That was an interesting pancake. What are they?
Now that's
Jesus
cute.
Christ.
Yeah, they like
they
rocked
beat
the hell
the
out of
crap
them.
Out of their knees. Yeah. All right.
Okay,
all right.
Okay.
Back to the top.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So
good stuff. Yeah,
the dancing's really good, but I feel like it's just like a little too choreographed, and like you can tell
always
it doesn't always go with the music exactly.
Yeah.
Always an issue with Strictly's.
Not always, though. Like you can totally have
often
like things in the pocket where you're like, oh, I feel this sort of thing coming up in the music, so we'll do this kind of combination that we've done once or twice before. You know, it doesn't have to be like, oh, I've already choreographed our entire 16 eights. That just
happens a lot, though.
But the dancing in that is real good. Nice job, everyone.
Thank you for that.
Mm-hmm.
And we should say,
that's a good palate cleanser.
As I'm moving all around the mic and driving Jim crazy.
Right, anyway.
Thank you for joining us today on Swing Nation. I'll do the sign off and the thanks if you don't mind, because I was gone half the show. I wasn't
that's
here.
True.
That's true. Some other guy.
Thanks to our host, Cafe Sophie. It's 3463 16th Street. Like, I don't know the address.
Fail.
Serving in San Francisco, serving fine Verve coffee beverages and Silk Road teas and tasty pastries. Cafe Sophie, sf.com. Thanks to Casey McGill for the awesome theme music. Mm-hmm. Thank you to Paul Marino, my buddy who was here in town, and I was sick all weekend, and I didn't really get to entertain him.
Wah.
Anyway, he did our show open, and one of the B-Boys, this is one, and then Jeremy Harris is the other
J-Blaze.
One.
Oh, J-Blaze, yeah.
And he did the backdrop.
Multi-talented.
JeremyHarrisDesigns.com. Contact us by email at news@yehudi.com. Facebook, where the Facebook group called Yehudi. Is it a Facebook group now or
no,
page?
No, it's a page. You can like us.
Page.
The group is gone. The girl is mine. On Twitter, it's at Yehudi, at Spuds, at Zuckerpunch, and at Rico-matic, and at Punk Ass Jim.
That's right.
Hey.
At Punk Ass Jim. Find out how the show is made. phone number 201-94-7469, 201-94-SHOW. Operators standing by. Review us on iTunes. And have yourselves a merry little Christmas.
What? Happy summer.
Bye, guys.
Happy June.
Talk to you next week.
See you soon.
A one and a two.
Truck on down.